to the empty net. Net presence, great stop there by Lundqvist. But somehow that puck finds its way right to the goal line and Henrique puts it in. But again, the play in the middle of the ice.
Right to Tache, to Bossy, shoots, he scores! Mike Bossy has his 50th goal! A standing ovation, 50 for Bossy, a minute 29 left in this game.
That far corner, through the screen, that's a bullet. Tachi's his second of the season.
What a ripper. He bookends all those overtime losses. The winner in St. Louis, the winner here in Big D. And
you can see, those are some young, sometimes it takes a while to learn that, but that's a natural goal scoring scorer going to a goal scoring place into that blue paint and it just bounces off his body.
Tucked it, the twirl, and then sheathed the weapon. Little problem sticking the landing at the end of it, but whatever.
Oh, Taylor Hall gets to the front of the net. Nothing. Got it quick to do about that. And look at the reaction for his first big goal of his career.
What does he do the next shift? He goes right back out and gets it. Matthews goes to the net. Bernier lets the rebound out. And what a play. There's the kick save, right on the tape, but Matthews Bernier knows it.
6-5. Never mind, empty net. Marleau sets up Matthews, and it is a 6-5 Leaf lead with 1:02 left.
To the blue line, Joki Haju, other side, Kane scores.
I just turned towards the bench, and there was a pack of what, 15 guys in a space of about 2 feet. On the bench.
Bitter, do they love and admire Gabe Landeskog?
Oh my gosh, you talk about solidifying.
Right here, this is quick, right, left. And he makes no mistake. That was pretty to watch right there. The young man put a good performance on. And he got some attention right there. I'll tell you.
Vers Yertzisleger, à Bourret, son tir, c'est bon.
What a ripper. He bookends all those overtime losses. The winner in St. Louis, the winner here in Big D.
Brilliant play off a turnover. And you know, I gotta say, Gallagher didn't drive the net, Steve. He stayed in the scene. He didn't get into traffic.
Cuts it off a great feed for Myers and Dustin Byfuglien.
Ryan Ellis in some trouble. Here's Laine, shoots, Laine stopped it. Stastny to Laine across the ice, score! Byfuglien has another!
Seam as the Senators work it around. The puck will go low. Clark McCarthy with a one-timer from Bobby Ryder. What a story! And what a goal!
Know too much about him. He was Nathan MacKinnon's line mate in junior. MacKinnon was the first pick. Groen was the third pick that year by the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Holtner! I guarantee this puck's going in. This guy's got hands. What do you think, Bob?
Kerr playing some center ice. Domi to Kerr. Snapshot. Save. Rebound. Score! Ty Domi!
What's this?
He's going for the line.
He can't help it.
Through Murray on a breakaway! 52 seconds in! Kuznetsov gives him the pterodactyl coming out of the corner.
Lang drops it back. Here comes Kasparaitis. He scores! Darius Kasparaitis! The Pittsburgh Penguins! 3-2 over the Sabres! They go against the Devils in the conference finals!
On this shift, this time, like, you know what? I could do that again, or I could just do this! Rip shot past Neuwirth. And yeah!
Anderson shoulder, nice pass from Marcus Foligno. And as you mentioned, Gord, the people came to watch Jack Eichel get on the board. He's had a real quiet night.
Andre Fleury, and that play right there that Malkin made. Their accidental play, the baby smile, and Sakura finishing it off. jumping into the doing the Lambeau leap. But look at Malkin, watch this.
By Zucker, they just can't contain the Wild on this play. Too many chances. And Zucker puts it away.
Forsberg and Ellis. Well, Jones and Forsberg both getting in on that one. And I think Hornquist might have been the one, Pete. Forsberg finished it off. Jones started with a shot.
Opportunity, a fortuitous bounce. And there's the wraparound. And there's the jump right there. Oh, he looked like his dad, didn't he? How about that?
A bullet. And Toronto, a tremendous comeback tonight.
And Foligno jumps as high as he's ever jumped after scoring a goal to beat the Red Wings in game 5-4.
And on a stick as it lays in front of Semyon Varlamov.
Eddie, the key to this, watch him in the neutral zone. It's a tough play for Shane O'Brien. There's a Foligno leap that Doc was alluding to.
Zaitsev makes the play in his own zone, a little quick up, and look at his eyes. Never looked at the puck, picked his spot, and there's a celebration.
The Alonka got tipped or not, but a quick release, similar to that Beagle goal earlier. Radulov, quick snapshot, a couple feet off the ice.
Rodziak iced the puck, face off in their zone. Upshaw gets sprung loose, one hand on his stick, the toe of the goaltender makes the save, and look at the reaction.
Feed from Nyquist. As we say, perform some magic 4-on-4 at that end of the ice a season ago to win it in overtime for Detroit. And now it's Nyquist who sets up Tatar as the Red Wings win it.
Oh, it hit the stanchion and came right back. What a heads-up play by Kevin Bieksa. Nobody knows where that puck is. Off the stanchion and right back. And look at the reaction.
But don't forget, I think this all stems from, remember the hit, watch this point. He's pointing right to him. Ah, it's awesome. He's telling him. And you know why? The hit in the first period, Crosby on Kozlov.
As you take a look right here as he comes across and just takes a wicked wrist shot that really was blown by McKenna before he could even move, even and the glove side to boot. So that just shows you how hard he had that shot.
Easy to skate without the puck instead of with it. But you see, they were all standing still. They weren't moving. And that allowed him to get in behind. And he finishes like no other. And that's the reason.
Happen to see you with Larkin. There it is. Scores! Larkin wins it from Happen to see you.
5 seconds left.
Oh, 4 seconds left in regulation time. Ovechkin out in front. They score! Joel! The question will be...
And here's the goal again as he goes to the net and then taps it in. And the pitchers tell the story.
Three great looks early in this period. But it's fourth time lucky for number 13. We're all tied up.
The Penguins now lead 9-4. And ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has just left the building.
Oh, a little moonwalk there.
The White Shoes walk.
Niemis wins the faceoff, and now Strome just loses it. Watch, he misfires on the play, but Anderson will get in, come up with the hit, and the puck, and the pass, and the finish.
For Dumba. Well, there's not a lot of players that can score from distance like this. I mean, that is in and out of the net so fast, and it's not even a flat pass. It's a little bit of a wobbler.
They're very sophisticated with how they can grab.
Hasn't scored in his last 13 games. Nice job setting the puck into speed for Ehlers, who navigates through the neutral zone. And Matthew Perreault, who comes in on the weak side wisely, puts himself in a pretty darn good spot to capitalize.
Strike. Everything was pretty on this play other than Greeny's celebration. Here's the shot, and then watch Greeny lose an edge. There he is, losing it.
Just like Foligno was a few minutes ago when he gave the puck up to Furlan. That's a bad angle goal that shouldn't go in.
What he's doing. His best two chances earlier in the year were both against Detroit. Boy, he went for a corner there, didn't he? Then what a reaction.
The puck got up and then got that backhander in.
Going to score his fourth goal in the season, and the Avalanche have tied it up in 3 here in the third period.
Look at that. Snap that puppy.
In the race up the ice, a breakaway for Dustin Byfuglien earlier in this game, and he doesn't make a mistake. All one motion. Doesn't give away the shot where he's going. His eyes are down.
Look
cannot express to you how hard it is to get all of that one like PK Subban did. And he knows who to thank for this one, Carey Price. Not only can he stop pucks, he can hit apparently.
5-on-3 situation. This becomes a 5-on-4. Bergeron in front of the net, and Pasternak's been doing it all season long.
He's looking for some help. Gomez passes off. Subban shoots. Scores! PK Subban!
Right back. Took the Bruins 32 seconds to tie it up. Jake DeBrusque makes it 3-3.
DeBrusque gets knocked down. But
in double OT.
Well, Patrick Kane with an incredible move right in front of Brian Elliott. Looked like he was going to shoot the puck.
He just throws it to the front, hits Vokoun, left leg, and then Sean Avery celebrates. Remember, stay away. One, two, three. That's it. Free. That's all it takes. The Kings lead 6-4.
That's a very difficult play for a goalie to make when you're going from one side of the net to the other. There's a little fake there. Moves and throws it 5-hole to win the game for the Detroit Red Wings.
Interception. The yawning cage for Kane. 2-0 Chicago.
Fights from behind the goal line to get to the front. Close call. Front turns and the puck just bounces to Joe Thornton, who wheels, fires, puts it in, celebrates, and the Sharks are on to the second.
Just see a kiss.
Well, same from Palfy. He's been. Hello. Uh-oh. How far can you go with this, boys? I know closeness is closeness.
With 54 goals. How did he celebrate? He went duck hunting. He needed a duck. He threw it up with one of the most unique celebrations ever, and we are happy.
Look at the goal. He has a real nice feel when to jump into the play from the side and go to the front of the net, and that's some celebration. Apparently, he didn't watch Coach's Corner again today because Grape's not going to be too happy. Brilliant hire. Dave Tippett is an excellent coach.
Here's a possible two-man break for the Sharks. Tomas Hertl scores his first National Hockey League goal, and it is a beauty.
Ristolainen going to get his second of the year, and it's a huge one. And wouldn't you know it, another defenseman stepping in and scoring a big goal for the Buffalo Sabres here.
Put the Red Wings up 2-1, but Riley Sheehan not shooting for a goal, but for opportunity. Comes off quick. Todd Bertuzzi, middle lane drive. That's what the Red Wings have been doing so well all night long. And then a salute to his father.
And what a passing play this is. One, two, there it is. Oh, that's it.
He gets tripped up, gets it to May, and over the line. He's May going in on goal. He shoots. He scores! May Day!
And Ellis has his first goal of the season.
It doesn't matter how. It just matters if it scores up on the score sheet. And look at the effort there. Out skates Ryan O'Reilly.
Does it get any better than this? Tiger Williams. More penalty minutes than anything else, but oh, when he scored, did he know how to celebrate? Get on that stick, you wicked witch, and ride it out.
Period two. Hyman gets to the front of the net. Two whacks at it. Congratulations, Zach Hyman, on his first NHL goal.
A moment he'll never forget.
The Trocheck. He fires and scores! Vinny Trocheck with a rocket. It's 2-1 Panthers.
And he is happy.